Hi guys, this is Tim from OCTV and I'm here in front of the GOC Stadium in Wuhan, China with Lucky Noob from Indonesia. Hi. Hi Lucky, how's it going?
Good. Quite cold actually.
It's really cold, so we are trying to make this very short. So yesterday was the GOC competition and today is more freestyle, but yesterday you performed really well. How did the day go?
Well, I got third place and to be honest, I didn't expect it because, you know, I'm not much of a 3D bencher. Usually I bench like 2Ds all the time, Super Pi and W Prime, Cinebench and stuff. And the bench was like 3D heavy. Because we have like only one 2D bench, the Super Pi with Galaxy Memory, and we have like three 3D benchmark, the 11, Firestrike and Firestrike Extreme, and it's 4.5 hours, I think. Yep. So in the first 2 hours, I was panicking a lot. Well, because I didn't really prepare for this event. I only test the sample card like 2 days before. Yeah. So, and the sample card has so many problems that I don't even know what to do with the card. So I just went with the new BIOS and hope everything's okay. And it turned out quite well, although I'm stuck in the 3D 11. I spent like almost 1 hour just trying to get one score and figure out what is going on with the card. And well, so to put it short, just lucky to put in the third place. Yeah.
Right, so like you said, the first part was 2D and that one was quite short. It was only SuperPi 32M.
Yeah.
How high were you running on your CPU for that one?
We have a CPU clock limit, about 6 GHz plus minus 12 MHz. So the main thing about the SuperPi was to maximize the memory, memory efficiency. And the memory was Hynix MFR chips, single side chips, and we don't usually use Hynix MFR. For a SuperPi, I mean, the performance really slow compared to Samsung or not even the lowest Samsung could produce a score that low. So we have to figure out the sweet spot, and it turned out to be like 2900-ish. To 933 through. Some people did run at 3000 though, okay. with quite tight timings. I think XA has a really, really good SuperPi 32M, he's the first. And as for me, I was running at like 2988, CL11, 14 something. Yeah. Oh, my last run was CL10 with like almost 2.1 volts. And the memory was like, fuck it. I was like, if it's going to die, then it's going to die. Yeah. That's it. I don't care.
So for the 3D part, there, like you said, you had to not so much experience with the graphics card.
Of course.
But in the end, like it turned out pretty well. What frequencies were you running for your graphics card?
At first, I was like stuck in like 2 gigahertz ish, like 1915 at 2 gigahertz, and I started putting like crazy voltage, like 1.67 to 1.7, and it turned out that the card has something more to squeeze. I end up my final clocks was 2080 to I did make like one Firestrike Extreme run with what to 100, I think. To 100, and that's with 1.74 volts. I mean, I almost get scared that the card's going to die, but it's okay. Yeah. So that last submission was with 1.7 volts at 2100. But the card was really good. I mean, I haven't tested all the GTX 980, but this is my first card, but it's easy to handle. You don't need to do any mods, any modifications.
Yeah.
So yeah, the card ran great.
Yeah. So what do you think about the event in general? Is it a cool event? You've been here last year.
Yeah.
And what do you think about this year's location?
Yeah, I think it's pretty much the same as last year. I mean, the event venue is, I think the size is the same. And we could actually really cool for them to combine a gaming event and an overclocking event. But just like last year, we only have like the gaming event, there's an announcer and something like
MC
that.
And
we have a really nice stage back there for OC, but there's not much going on. I mean, not much announcing that this overclocker got some scores and that overclocker got some scores. You see the competition going, but this year, we could just barely see the scoreboard. The fonts are really small.
The public attending is not so much aware of what's going on.
They're really excited. They say, oh, there's smoke and there's hardwares, but what they're going to do with that?
Yeah.
What they're aiming? when and actually there is a some guy actually who knows English, and try to you know have a conversation with us, and they're asking what's the benchmarks, and we're explaining them that we're doing extreme overclocking, and they was like excited, and but they didn't know what's happening in the event because there is no one to announce it.
Yeah. Yeah. A great event, but yeah, always a few things to improve. Yeah. Right?
Overclocking is a kind of technical sport, so you have to you know have a lot of cameras. Maybe you know project the screens of the contestant to see what they are doing, what are the voltage, you know who's doing what.
All right. Well, we'll see that for next year. Then I guess we'll suggest that to Galax.
But you know, I think this event this year is really good because they have the qualifier.
Yep.
So you know, no one gets grumpy because I didn't get invited, something like that. Yeah,
it's already a nice improvement from
last year. That's a very big improvement, and I like the individual battles. It put much more stress to the overclocker.
Stress is good. I'm always into making things a bit shorter to put more stress. But then, yeah, most people they are more relaxed benching kind of style.
Yeah.
All right. Well, thanks, Lucky, for your time, and congrats again for third place. And we'll see you very soon in Indonesia, I suppose.
Yeah. Okay. So see you guys.
Yeah.
Bye.